morning.
Good morning.
This morning, the miracles of our Lord Jesus, we see led God's people to say, God does everything well. May we also voice those praises of our God today, not just when things are going super well, but at all times, that the Lord knows what's best for us, and that the Lord, according to his promise, will work all things out for the good. May the Lord bless our worship. We'll begin with hymn 517. Isaiah the prophet, we read from chapter 35. Tell those who have a fearful heart, be strong. Do not be afraid. Look, your God will come with vengeance. With God's own retribution, he will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind will be opened, and the ears of the deaf will be unplugged. The crippled will leap like a deer, and the tongue of the mute will sing for joy. Waters will flow in the wilderness, and streams in the wasteland. The burning sand will become a pool, and in the thirsty ground there will be springs of water. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm for today, we will be singing hymn number 758 as we celebrate the beginning of another school year in our Sunday school program. We pray, let children hear the mighty deeds. So that he could beg for donations from those entering the temple. When he saw Peter and John about to enter the temple, he asked them for a donation. Peter looked directly at him, as did John. Peter said, "Look at us." So the man paid close attention to them, expecting to receive something from them. Peter said, "Silver and gold I do not have, but what I have, I will give you. In the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, get up and walk." Peter took him by the right hand and raised him up. And immediately the man's feet and ankles were made strong. Jumping up, he stood and began to walk. He entered the temple courts with them, walking, jumping, and praising God. All the people saw him walking and praising God. They recognized him as the one who used to sit begging for money at the beautiful gate of the temple. And they were filled with wonder and amazement at what had happened to him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the reading of the gospel. The gospel lesson is taken from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 7. We begin with verse 31. Jesus left the region of Tyre again and went through Sidon to the Sea of Galilee, within the region of the Decapolis. They brought a man to him who was deaf and had a speech impediment. They pleaded with Jesus to place his hand on him. Jesus took him aside in private, away from the crowd. He put his fingers into the man's ears. Then he spit and touched the man's tongue. After he looked up to heaven, he sighed and said, "Ephphatha," which means "be open." Immediately the man's ears were opened, his tongue was set free, and he began to speak plainly. Jesus gave the people strict orders to tell no one, but the more he did so, the more they kept proclaiming it. They were amazed beyond measure and said, "He has done everything well. He even makes the deaf hear and the mute speak." This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise be to you, O Christ.
Please be seated for our next hymn, 537. What might you be afraid? or maybe fear is a strong word, of what are you worried about? Concerned? It could be very much your own personal health. It could be the health of a loved one. It could be very well the state of affairs in our country and in our world today. Inflation, an election year, crime, wars throughout the world, natural disasters. There certainly is a lot, as you turn on the TV, there's a lot of things to make us worried and concerned, and to keep our mouths shut as far as saying the words that were said in the gospel, Lord, you do everything well. It sure doesn't seem like it. Brothers and sisters in Christ, even as we go through this veil of tears, the Lord is our shepherd. The Lord is our good shepherd that continually provides for us and takes care of us. And that fact drives away all worry, concern, fear. Brothers and sisters in Christ, we do not need to be afraid, for the Lord is our God, who has already come to save, and he is coming again to save. And he comes to us time after time through his word and through his sacraments, and he reminds us, I am with you always. God's people, Israel, were in a difficult time in their history. They were a divided nation. Part of it had been taken away into captivity already. This was God's just discipline, judgment on the people. For they had worshipped other gods. They had trusted in the armies of other nations to save them. They did not trust in the Lord. And the Lord had warned them about that. If you turn away from me, I will turn my face away from you. So the people were worried and concerned. What's going to happen to us now? The Assyrians are coming to attack us. What's going to happen to us in the future? The Babylonians are becoming powerful. Isaiah prophesied at that time, speaking the words of God, tell those who have a fearful heart, which there are many in Israel, be strong. Do not be afraid. Look, your God will come with vengeance, with God's own retribution. He will come and save you. God's people needed to be reminded of this truth, that even though things didn't seem that they were going the best, the Lord is their God. Our God. Our God, who is a holy God and demands perfect obedience and is only right in disciplining us, in that we might repent and trust in the Lord more. The Lord is coming on Israel because of their vengeance. I don't mean right now, but because of their disobedience. He's coming on that nation of Israel because of their idolatry. But God had promised for his people that he's coming to save them. He would bring them out of Assyria. He would bring them out of Babylon. He would bring them again to that promised land. And he would one day provide his own son to be the savior of them all. As New Testament Christians, we look and see, yes, indeed, our Lord has come to save us. We celebrate his coming at Christmas. We celebrate his sacrifice, which accomplishes our salvation, on Good Friday. And we continue that celebration into Easter, being reminded that through Jesus' resurrection, we are all justified from our sins. We continue that celebration on into Ascension. 40 days after the Lord's resurrection, the Lord is going now to prepare a place for us, to come back and then take us to be with him where he is forever. Brothers and sisters in Christ, we all have worries, concerns, fears. And the Lord comes to us and says, don't be afraid, be strong. And we might want to ask God something, well, how can that be? How can I not be afraid and not have these worries? Look to the cross. Look to that empty tomb. God has saved you. You are dear and precious in God's sight. In baptism, the Lord washed you of all of your sins, clothed you with his righteousness, and in the Lord's Supper, he continues to remind you, you are forgiven. That's how we find strength given to us by the Holy Spirit to keep pushing on in this veil of tears, come what may. We can still say by the grace and power of God, he does everything well. I may not understand everything that's happening, but who am I to understand his infinite wisdom? What he does is good. His mercy endures forever. When the Lord came and brought salvation, he also brought many wonderful blessings that come with that salvation. Blessings that are described in the closing verses of our text. Eyes of the blind being opened, ears of the deaf being unplugged, crippled, leaping like a deer, the tongue of the mute singing for joy. Think of it, apart from faith in Christ, apart from knowing that the Lord is our God and our Savior, these eyes are by nature blind. They look around this world, they look for hope, they look for certainty, and they cannot find it except for the fact that they know someday we're all going to die. But these eyes are given new ability, they're given sight through the Word of God. That they can say, as Stephen the Martyr did, I can see the Lord Jesus sitting at the right hand of God in power and glory. That's what we can see too, because of God's word, because of the truths, the wonderful truths revealed in them. Our ears, which once upon a time couldn't stand to hear what God has to say, longs now to hear what God says. And gradually, more and more, by the Spirit, gets to understand things more. Not perfectly, not till we're in heaven. But to know that the Lord is our God and is with us and is working everything out for our good. These are truths our ears love to hear. The cripple, that we couldn't walk in God's ways one little bit. We always went to the right or like to the left, like wandering sheep, always going astray. But the Lord comes to us in word and sacrament, gives us his Spirit, and he helps us to walk in his way, honoring his gift of marriage, serving as faithful parents and leaders, being obedient to our authorities, and the tongue of the mute singing for joy. This tongue is so powerful and dangerous. It can be used to hurt people. It can be used to offend people. Yet it's so hard for people to use this tongue to say they're sorry and to bless one another. This tongue is enabled to sing for joy, to serve the Lord as it gets to hear God's word and is reminded God is with us always to the very end of the age. So we wake up in the morning by the power of the Holy Spirit. We ask, Lord, how can I serve you today? My hands, my eyes, with my ears, with my tongue. How might I praise and thank you for all that you've done for me? And the description goes on in our text. Waters flowing in the wilderness, streams in the wasteland. The burning sand will become a pool, and in the thirsty ground there will be springs of water. As you look in the Old Testament, you see what God did for his people Israel, providing them with manna on the desert floor during their journey for 40 years, providing water in miraculous ways, sometimes out of a rock, solid rock. Apostle Paul said that that rock that accompanied God's people was Christ. And our Lord Jesus, we've heard it recently read from the Gospel of John, reminds us, come to me. Come to me. I am the bread of life. I satisfy your spiritual hunger. I come to you with waters of life, that they spring up in you to eternal life. Apart from God, apart from God's word, these hearts of ours, our souls, are like a barren wilderness. There's no life to them whatever. But thanks be to God who gives us the Holy Spirit and who leads us to see Jesus is the Christ. There is waters flowing in our hearts. These waters, however, needing to be refreshed as we continue to hear and study God's word. Our text tells us what was given instruction to Isaiah. Tell those who have a fearful heart, be strong, do not be afraid. Sunday school teachers, parents, the Lord has entrusted to you, children of the next generation. His will is that we talk to them, because they may not always seem like it. Maybe there's a strong storm and they'll be afraid of storm. But by nature, they are fearful just like we are. They have worries and concerns too. We are blessed that we get to tell them, be strong. Don't be afraid. We can tell one another, be strong. Don't be afraid. But don't just leave it at that. Tell them how and why they can be strong and not afraid. Tell them, because God is coming. He has come. He has come to save you. He is coming again to save you. And remind them. Continue to hear these things from the scriptures. Be strengthened by them. Be refreshed in them. And they will fill your life with such great joy, because you can now see, you can hear, you can jump and walk, and you can praise God with a joyful tongue. All proofs and signs that God loves you dearly, bringing you to faith in Jesus. May God help us with our Sunday school program and our Bible studies. May God help all of our Christian schools to proclaim the good news of Christ crucified and risen, to tell fearful hearts, be strong, don't be afraid. God is your Savior. God is with you always. Amen. Please rise. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will continue to guard you and keep you in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. We join in now confessing our faith given to us by God. We confess the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the community. the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
At this time, our thank offering will be brought before the Lord. Gracious Lord, you are the giver of every good and perfect gift. We thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus, who has come to save us and will come again. We thank you for the gift of the Holy Spirit, that we might believe and confess Jesus as Lord. We thank you for your word, which makes us wise to salvation through faith in Jesus. We thank you for the opportunities you've given us today and always. Go and gather disciples from around the world, from all nations, including people in our community, that all people might believe in you and be saved. We pray for your blessings on our Sunday school program. We pray that you'll use these thank offerings to support all the work we do and our church does for the glory of your name. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Please be seated. At this time, we will have the installation of our Sunday school teachers. Our Lord and Savior Jesus said to his church, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age." Our Savior loves children and desires to share all his promises with them. Our Sunday school gives us a unique opportunity as a congregation to nourish the faith of children, so that they may walk with Christ throughout their lives. Dear sisters in Christ, you have agreed to serve as teachers for our Sunday school program. As servants of Christ, you are to teach lessons from God's Word and lead your students to understand God's holy law and saving gospel. Keep them in your prayers and guide and guard their spiritual growth. You are to set aside time for personal study of the Scriptures so that you may grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. You are to strive to be an example of Christian faith and life so that others may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. In all your tasks and responsibilities, our Lord Jesus equips you with the gospel of the forgiveness of sins, the gift that makes you truly competent as servants of Christ. St. Paul wrote, "Not that we are competent in ourselves to claim anything for ourselves, but our competence comes from God." In keeping with the word and will of the Lord, I ask you before God and his people, will you diligently and faithfully carry out the work entrusted to you according to the ability which God gives you? If so, answer, "I will, and I ask God to help me."
I will, and I ask God to help me.
Members of St. Peter's, you have heard the promises of your sisters in Christ. Support them as they serve and teach our children, so that they may be brought up in the training and instruction of our Lord. Keep our Sunday school teachers in your prayers, that their ministry may be blessed and that they might carry out their work with joy. And children of St. Peter's, the Savior calls on you to honor and obey your teachers and instructors so that their work may bring them joy and be a blessing to you. As you learn from your Sunday school teachers, show your love for Jesus by respecting and listening to them, especially since they are sharing with you God's word, which is the word of life. I now install you as Sunday school teachers at St. Peter's Lutheran Church, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lucy Lipke, Audrey Lipke, Allie Lipke. May the Lord pour out on you his Holy Spirit for the work you've been called to do, that you may faithfully carry out all the duties and responsibilities with the Word of God as your confidence and guide. Let us pray. Almighty God, source of all wisdom, we thank you for the opportunity we have to send our children to Sunday school and to Christian schools. May your life-giving word be the center of all teaching and every activity, so that all may come to know and believe your holy law and saving gospel. Equip our teachers with spiritual wisdom that they may faithfully carry out the duties of this call. Move our students to godly obedience and cause them to grow throughout their instruction in your word throughout the year. We ask for your blessings in Jesus' name. Amen. May the Lord now bless you and make your ministries to be a blessing to others. Amen. We will continue our order of service with the next song, with hymn number 909.
Oh,
rise for prayer. We include in our prayers today a special petition of thanksgiving on behalf of our brother in Christ, Mark, who is celebrating today his 90th birthday with family, with friends. We also pray on behalf of two brothers in Christ who have illnesses that they are dealing with, Lyle Brophy, who's with us this morning, and also John McClain, who is in the hospital this morning. Let us pray. O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, continue to inspire us with your love and faithfulness, that we may grow in our love for you, and may mature in our willingness to serve you and worship you all our days. Forgive us for the many times we have not loved you with all of our hearts. Forgive us for the times we've forgotten about you and your power, and have foolishly trusted in ourselves or others to get things done. Be with us and guide us with your word. Draw us ever closer to you and to each other through the good news of our salvation. Lord God, maker of heaven and earth, our times are in your gracious and powerful hands. Look with favor on your servant, Marvin Mark, as he celebrates his 90th birthday today. Fill his heart with joy and thanksgiving over the love you have shown him in your word, and in the many blessings you have given him throughout his life. Grant that he may continue to grow in wisdom and grace, and help him to trust in your goodness to watch over him and care for him all the days of his life. Lord God, physician of our bodies and souls, in your mercy you transform even sickness and disease into a blessing for your children. With this confidence, we commit all who are sick or suffering to your tender care. We pray especially for our brothers in Christ, Lyle Brophy and John Plain. Provide healing and relief to your servants, according to your infinite wisdom and never-failing love. Be with them and help them to fix their eyes on you, their God and their Savior, the one who does all things well, and the one who works all things out for the good of those who love you. Give your servants and all who are sick and suffering the peace of their forgiveness and the joy of their salvation. O Lord, through word and sacrament, live in us that we may live for you. We pray these things in Jesus' name, and we also join in praying the prayer he has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. The Almighty and Merciful Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless us and keep us.
Amen.
Please be seated for our closing hymn to 910.
Thank you.
morning.
Good morning.
We'd like to welcome those who are visiting with us. Glad you could come and worship with us. We invite you to come and worship the Lord again with us as we get the opportunity to gather in His Word and in His sacraments and be reminded time and time again of God's presence with us and His love that He provides for us. Certainly things we do not deserve. Today is the beginning of our Sunday school program. We thank those that have volunteered to serve as our Sunday school teachers. Also those that didn't come forward but will be serving as substitute teachers. We thank everybody that will make this possible. We do wish the Lord's blessings on the teaching of His Word to the next generation. For us adults, that doesn't mean we're not going to study God's Word. We'll keep having Bible study at the same time the Sunday school program is going on. So from 10:15 to 10:45, roughly, we will have Bible study today. I'm just recalling that there is a ladies' aid meeting scheduled too, so maybe the Bible study might get started a little bit later this morning, but we'll start with the ladies' aid meeting shortly after church, where? In the back of the church. So don't go far away. Don't get your coffee donuts quite yet, right? No coffee donuts. Nothing. Okay. One thing I didn't put in the bulletin, maybe catechism students were thinking, oh, we've got another week with no catechism. No, it's going to start this Wednesday, 6:30. I look forward to seeing returning students and new students. 6:30 this Wednesday is our first lesson. Finally, I guess I'd like to just say thank you to everybody that helped with our little booth over at the Fall Fest. It was a nice day. It wasn't so rainy or windy or cold, so thanks be to God for that. We met a lot of nice people from the community. A lot of children saw that even animal balloons do pop. We had a little cemetery next to Glen, and there's so many that pop this year. And there are many other opportunities, the face painting, the tattoos, and prizes were handed out. We're kind of cleaned up from all of our prizes, so we're going to look for more prizes to bring out next year. And thanks to those that came last night for fellowship to watch the fireworks. As always, next year, if you didn't come, you got great seats to see the fireworks right from our place as they shoot them off right there. That's all the announcements I have, except please consider scheduling an appointment for having your picture taken. The Pictorial Directory is taking place Monday, September 30th, and Tuesday, October 1st. And Cheryl Vick can help you get registered in the library area to do that today. Talk to me or Cheryl Vick if you have any questions about this. That's all the announcements I have. God bless you and keep you until we see you again.